Good morning, everybody. Hello, everybody. Let's start our class now. Hello.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning. Hello. Okay, let's see. Let's gonna start our class today. Let me remember you the center of interest and our value, okay? For that reason, I need to share my PowerPoint. Okay, so let me stop my music so we can start. Let's see, the last one. Okay, let's see. Okay, let me share my screen so you can remember. You can remember. Okay, that's our center of interest, right? We prepare to celebrate our 66th institutional anniversary in the time of COVID-19. Yes, we know that all this month we are preparing for the anniversary, right? Okay. What else? Let me see. Okay, our value. Our value in this month, ours, is respect. And we are showing different kinds to show respect actually in these internet classes online now. Okay. So in the other class, you already mentioned many ways to practice respect in class. I remember that you told me about to stand your hand, to use the emojis or the action, sorry, the action icon to tell me that you wanna participate, or maybe make me a sign on the webcam so I can give you, I give you pass to talk, right? Not just interrupt the class. Okay, that's respect. To be on time is to show respect to. Another ways, not to correct to your friends in class, or maybe not to jump, no burlándose about them, right? In class too. It's another way to respect opinions, maybe because not only in English, could be in another courses. You can give your opinions. There is difference of your partners, and you have to listen that and to respect, right, the position of the other person. Okay, and there is a lot another ways to show respect in this case. Now to eat in class, for example, don't eat in class, don't eat. That's another way to show respect too. Okay, so it's the same that you show that in the present classes, right? You didn't eat, I guess that you didn't eat in class, so it's gonna be the same here in online classes. So what we are going to learn today, okay, today we're gonna talk about in past. So we're gonna start with the affirmative sentence, okay? For that, I need that you remember. Do you remember that the last class we worked regular and irregular verbs? Okay. And I told you that it's really common or is useful actually for simple, I'm sorry, it's past. I write here simple present, right? But it's past, no, it's present, okay? Sorry, I was really excited yesterday, I guess. Okay, so these verbs that we have learned the last class, regular and irregular verbs, we're gonna use that now in our sentence in simple past. Okay, that we're gonna learn today to make sentence in affirmative using the simple past. Okay, to refresh our mind, para refrescar nuestra memoria, and to practice a little bit, we're gonna make dynamics, vamos a hacer una dinámica, about the verbs, okay? So for that reason, I need that everybody wake up, sorry. I need that everybody open your webcam. Wake up too, right? Okay, I need that everybody open your webcam to participate in these dynamics. Todos, por favor, open your webcam. Todos abrimos nuestra cámara para participar in these dynamics. Everybody, please. Mom. Hello, Dido. Hello, everybody over there. Alex, Micaela, Hazel, very good. Hello, Camila. Okay, come on, everybody. Everybody, open your webcam so you can participate in this part, okay? Come on. Jericho, I'm waiting. Maricielo. Yes, Brian, Andrew, Emerson, Natalie, Fabricio. Come on, quickly, quickly.
Mimi, ahorita me estoy peinando, me dice.
Oh, come on, Fabricio. Son las 9, recién estás peinando. Que tú tienes de Rapunzel, usted seguro. Ok, come on, everybody. Come on, Andrew, Jericho, Natalie, Emerson. Yeah, you have to be ready. ¿Eh? Es igual como estar en clases. ¿Eh? A las 10 recién me estoy peinando. I'm sorry. No, yeah, no. ¿Eh? Ok, come on. Good. Es una broma por si acaso, amigo. ¿Eh? Ok, so... I'm gonna tell you the
verbs. Un ratito. Ahorita lo prendo, permíteme, por favor.
Okay. Okay, Andrew, Emerson, I'm waiting. Jericho, Maricielo, please. Okay, you have to be ready. Pueden ya están listos, okay? So, I'm gonna tell you the verb. Voy a decirles el verbo in present. And you're gonna change this verb in past, okay? So, remember, be careful if the verb is regular or irregular verb, okay? Tienes que hacer el cambio adecuado, you know that. Okay, another thing, I'm gonna tell you this verb in, okay, I'm gonna tell you this verb orally, okay? So, listen very well. I don't gonna write this verb. Y tienen carta libre para abrir el micro y decirme nada más el verbo. No alcen la mano. En este caso no van a alzar la mano, no van a pedir permiso. Just open your microphone and tell me the answer, okay? So, what is the past? What is the past for visits? Visit, de visitar. What is the past for visits?
Visited.
Yes. Visited. Very good. Visited. It's a regular verb, right? Okay. What is the past for try, de tratar, try? What is the past for try?
Drive it.
Try it, okay, yes. I'm gonna write that in the chat so everybody can see. Try it, that's the past for try. Ah, oh, Maricielo. Arlette, well, okay, try it. What is the past for eat? Eat.
Eight.
Very good. Do you remember the rats? When I say eat, you say eight. Okay, eight, very good. Remember that because sometimes we, even that the writing is different, a veces lo pronunciamos igual, means eat, is eight el pasado, okay? Good. What is the past for do? What did. Is the past for do? Did, very good. Be careful with that because did is the auxiliary that we're gonna use more. Vamos a usar un montón de it, okay? Now that we are gonna do simple past sentence. So, what is the past for buy, comprar, buy?
Bought.
Yes, Hazel?
Bought.
Both, very good. What is the writing? Es difícil, no? Okay, here, there is in the shop, both, very good. What is the past for go? Go.
Went.
Go. Went, right? Good. Went. What is the past for say? De decir, say. Say. Say.
Oh.
What is the past for say? Yes? Say significa decir, ¿eh? What is the past for say? Come on, Camila, hey. Melie. Said. Very good. Said. So, yeah, I'm going to write that in the past. Here. Okay. There is the past in the shop. Said. Okay. What is the past for the bear to be? Be. What is the past for the bear to be? Be.
Was.
Sorry. Was and? Was
and were.
Was and were. Okay. Chicos, cuando yo utilizo el was y el were, significa lo mismo, ¿ah? Hay una diferencia y ahorita la voy a explicar. Pero ese es el pasado del verbo to be. I was, yo fui, yo estuve. ¿Ok? ¿Ok? Y el were igual. Pero ¿cuándo utilizo el was y cuándo utilizo el were? A ver, ¿quién me dice? Who told me?
Eso es con...
¿Significa lo?
¿Qué? Was es con she, he, it.
Ok. And where?
From we, they, you, and I.
Very good, very good. I know, I know. Ok, I is we, no, no, was.
Okay. Was so, es con the word I, y el where it is it.
Yes. Yes, justamente iba a reforzarlo. Yes, but that's good, Micaela, good idea. So, I use was para I, he, she, it. Ok, tercera persona y primera, ¿no? I también. Y uso el were para you, they, we. Ok, you were, they were, we were. Ok, no es exactamente singular y plural porque I no es singular, es plural, apúntenlo ahí, como Hazel está haciendo, ¿ok? No, me estaba jugando. No, apúntenlo, por favor, así no se les pasa, porque vamos a ver bastante was y were in the simple past too, ¿ok? Remember again, was is for I, he, she, it. Ahí está dentro. Yeah. Y were is for they, we, and you. El you, singular o plural, ¿ah? Para decir tú o ustedes igualito. You were all the time.
Okay. ¿Y es el I de, el I que llevaría?
I was. I was. Ok, el I es con was. Chicos, por favor, yo no he dicho cierren su cámara. No sé por qué el resto ya cerró ya. Ya voy a cerrar, ya la misma he dicho nada. No tengo que estarte repitiendo. He dicho que por esta actividad... Please, everybody, open your webcam. En ningún momento he dicho que lo cierren. Ahí, Meli, Piero, Ibrahim, Alexandra, I don't know why you close your webcam. Please open that. Okay, what is the past for drink? What is the past for drink?
Drunk.
Drunk. Very good, Dajali. Drunk. Very good. What is the past for walk? De caminar. Walk. What is the past for walk? Walk it. Very good. Okay. Now I guess that you are ready to make the simple past because you already remember many of these verbs. There is a lot. Yes, there is a lot. But I guess that did, was he weird, and another like ate, ran, walked, they are very common, right? So now let's start. Ahora sí, chicos, si desean, you can close your webcam. Ahora sí, let me show my screen so you can see the class for today, okay?
Mi, su micro está apagado.
Sí, está apagado, es que como me fui, I don't know por qué se fue un ratito el sistema. Ok, tenemos tenemos delegado en el salón o delegada, no, right? So let me choose one of you. Voy a escoger a cualquiera de ustedes por su rendimiento, porque presenta tareas a tiempo, because it's on time, could be a girl, could be a boy, I don't know. Este delegado va a tener ciertas funciones, ¿ok? Y sí, no voy a dejarle tarea extra por si acaso, ¿ok? Y sus funciones van a ser generalmente online, o sea, en clase, ¿ok? So, let me see. Obviamente que va a tener beneficios también, porque ayuda, tiene que tener ciertos beneficios. Ok, let's see. Ok, vamos a cambiar cada mes, ok? For this month, o cada bimestre, sorry. For this bimestre is going to be Hazel. Ok, Hazel, can you open your webcam, please? Ok, Hazel, vas a ser delegada del aula, ¿ya? Ok, tu función hoy día, para empezar, is going to write the date, va a ser escribir la fecha, ok, in the chat so everybody can see. Solo por hoy, porque la próxima clase va a escribir alguien más. And please, Hazel, cuando salga la indicación del Zoom, que esté ya 10 minutos o 5 minutos antes de terminar, let me know, me hace saber por privado, Miss, ya va a acabar el tiempo. ¿Para qué? Para tomar la foto de la asistencia, porque siempre me olvido, mi amor, ¿ya? Ese es uno. Y dos, por si acaso, si es que no estoy grabando en clase, let me know, déjame saber. Miss no está grabando, ¿ok? Eso es por ahora, Hazel. ¿Va a haber otras cosas que me vas a ayudar? Sí, ¿ok? Pero por el momento, for today, just that, solamente eso, ¿ok? So let me know 10 minutes before the Zoom finish to take the list, ¿ok? To take the print to take for the list, okay? So everybody clap for Hazel, it's gonna be our delegate. Vamos, todos nuestros reaction clacks, okay? Come on, everybody. Okay. Good. ¿Por qué escriben corazones? He dicho clacks nada más. No, just kidding. Okay, let's see. Okay, so, sí, ay, no puedo ver el chat, pues, ¿qué ha pasado? No. En el Zoom. Okay, everybody, I don't think so, no creo, Hazel, no creo. You just kidding, right? Estás bromeando. Okay, so let's see. Let's go to the PowerPoint now. Okay, so our topic for today is the simple past. Hazel, please don't forget to write the dates. Escribe la fecha for today in the chat, okay? So you already know about regular verbs. Remember that the regular verbs, in this case, you just add ed, sometimes d, or sometimes ied, right? Dependiendo de la regla que ya hemos hecho la semana pasada. For example, arrived, call, college, wait, waited, marry, married, study, okay? So that happens in regular verbs. Okay, and in regular verbs, you usually change all the words and you have a little list, es una pequeña lista aquí, que puedes utilizar después para hacer oraciones, okay? Bring, brought, buy, bought, catch, cow, feel, felt, find, found, get, goat, have, had, heard, okay, keep, hit, leave, left, lose, made, read, say, sell, sold, sense, teach, dove, seen, dove, win, warm. Very good. Okay, now that we're gonna do here, okay, what is the structure for, ¿cuál es la estructura del simple past? Let's gonna do it together, okay? I'm gonna do the first example, voy a hacer el primer ejemplo, aquí lo voy a cambiar en simple past, and then juntos vamos a construir la estructura. Y ya sabemos, creo. Okay. I cooked chicken for lunch. Who wanna change this sentence in negative? Sorry, in simple past. Está en simple present. ¿Quién quiere cambiar esta oración en simple past? A ver, any volunteer? Yes, any volunteer? Okay, Hazel, please change this sentence in simple past.
I cooked.
I cooked.
Okay, that's it. Yes, you have to change the verb and that's it. I cooked chicken for lunch, and maybe we can add here for lunch. Okay, it's that's okay. No necesario ni siquiera poner lunch, the last lunch, anything. ¿Se entiende? Yo cociné pollo para la cena, ¿no? I cooked chicken for lunch. Okay, what is the structure? Do you see? Do you see? What is the first word? Is the pronoun or subject? After that, it is the verb in past. And the complement. That's it. It's all that I need, right? So, vamos a ponerlo aquí en nuestra pizarra y escríbelo. It's necessary for you. Si es necesario. Okay, yes. Hazel already write the date on the chat. Today is Tuesday, August 25, 2020. Very good, Hazel. Thank you. Ya está en el chat la fecha. Somebody's you quiere tomar notas. O bueno, tiene que tomar notas, please. You can write the the date, please, over there. So the structure is subject. Okay, the structure is subject. Cuando decimos subject, puede ser pronombre también, tú ya sabes, right? Subject plus, what else? Verb. Past verb. Vamos a poner el past verb, porque sepas que es el verbo en pasado. Past verb. Plus, what else? Complements. Complements. Okay, that's it. So when you're gonna make your sentence in affirmative, oh, obviously, I'm talking about affirmative, ¿eh? Porque cambia cuando es negativo y cuando es interrogative. But today we are gonna work just the affirmative way. So you use subject, past verb, and the complement. Okay? Yes, any question? That's okay, Dayali. That's okay, don't worry. Okay, so for example, let's gonna make a sentence here. You ate a lot, you ate a lot yesterday. Okay. Okay. You can use, acá también puedes usar frecuencia, sobre todo para indicar que es pasado. But it's no obligatory. Es para hacer sí más consistente tu respuesta, para que tenga más sentido, más cuerpo, ¿ok? Pero you can say to I ate a lot, and that's it. Ya se entiende, ¿ok? Por eso que no lo pongo aquí en the structure. What else? What else? Let's see another one. Okay, you ate a lot yesterday. Mary, oh, sorry. Okay, Mary danced very well last night. Okay. Okay, Mary danced very well, danced, no? Mary danced very well last night. Okay, so you already know the structure, so we are ready to make our sentence. Let's see, let's go. So let's come back to our PowerPoint. So any question under here? If everything is okay, give me a light, please. Give me a light. Dame un light si todo está, si todo está claro, clear. Okay. No questions. Okay, good. So let's go to the next one. Now that you, what you're gonna do, you're gonna change this sentence in past, okay? Todos ellos están en presente. Nos vamos a cambiar a pasado. Okay, let's go with the next one, with the second one. They wash the dishes. Okay, can you change this sentence in past? Any volunteer? Yes, no se peleen. Hay tiempo para todos. Okay, come on. Any volunteer, come on, do it. Okay, so if there isn't any volunteer, I'm gonna call a victim, huh? Okay, let's see. Okay, no volunteers. Okay, let me call somebody of you. Okay, el día nosotros tenemos hoy hasta las, sorry, de 9 y 10 a 10 y 10, ¿verdad? Y ahí vamos a ir hasta las 10 y 10, porque de ahí ya, sí tenemos tiempo. Okay, so Micaela, please, can you change the
Miss, micrófono.
Okay, now can you hear me, right? Okay, Micaela, please, can you change the second sentence, please?
They washed the dishes.
Okay, very good. They washed the dishes. Very good. Okay, what about Valentino, please, the third one? Can you change the third one in negative? We walk to school. What is the past for this sentence, Zabaleta?
El negativo.
No, you, in affirmative, the past, pero pasado. Yeah. Valentino, por favor, baja el volumen, deja de mirar la Laura Bozzo, creo. Okay, Valentino, Zabaleta, come on, quickly. We walked. Okay, that's it, the verb. We walk to school, that's it. Okay, Jericho, please, can you change the fourth one? La cuarta, we drink milk in the morning. We, Jericho, Sanchez. Sanchez, are you here? Okay, Sanchez is not here. Let's see. Apasa, please. Apasa. Okay, Apasa is not here. Piero Martel, please. We.
Sí, miss.
Yes. Change this sentence in negative. The fourth. La cuarta.
¿Cuál es el negativo de los cinco?
Sí, pero no, solamente de la cuarta oración, cámbialo en no en negativo, cámbialo a pasado. We drink milk in the morning. How do you say that in past, en pasado? We
drunk.
We drank, right?
Drank milk in the morning.
Okay, we drank milk in the morning. Very good. Okay, yes. Any volunteer to make the last one? Over there? No? Okay, let me call somebody. Okay, Murga, please. Change the last sentence. We eat pizza for dinner. We eat pizza for dinner. Okay, Murga. Yes, Rijik, tell me.
¿Ya tienes de primero de secundaria?
¿De primero de secundaria? ¿Por qué de primero de secundaria? ¡Ah, la clase! ¡Brigitte! ¡No, Brigitte! ¡Te has equivocado! Yo no sé de primero para...
Es que, yo estoy ingresando hace rato de la Miss Jenny y me dice que el IDL no es válido. Estoy que ingreso varias veces y ingresé, lo estoy pensando que, o sea, es lo mismo y... Pero recién me aceptó de usted, pero de la Miss Jenny no me acepta.
No, mi amor, no es, no es la misma clase. Yo estoy en tercera secundaria.
¿Pero pasa?
No, es Frigi quien me está hablando.
Se lo tengo que escribir.
En todo caso, sal de clase y pregúntale a tu tutora. ¿Algún problema debe estar pasando?
Y a mí.
O a la delegada de tu aula de las mamitas. Okay. Yes, okay. Yes, Murga, tell me. What is the past for the last sentence? Miss. We eat pizza for dinner. Yes, tell me.
¿Se lo tengo que escribir o decírselo?
No, just tell me orally. ¿Dónde? Chico, por favor. Si estamos así, estamos en la pregunta 5.
Ya hicimos. Pizza for dinner.
Okay, we ate. Very good. We ate pizza for dinner. Forever. For dinner. Huh? Okay. Good. Good, 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 good. Very good. So let's go to the next part. Okay. Now, what we're going to do now? What we're going to do now? Okay. You're going to write your sentence. Okay. Write how many sentences? Let me see. Write 3 sentences in simple past. Okay. You can use any verb. Me lo vas a mostrar en el chat o puedes usar la pizarra interactiva que acabo yo de mostrar hace un rato. Or you can use a paper to show me on the webcam, I don't know. Okay, or you can tell me that orally to your sentence, okay? So right now, you have only 2 minutes to make your 3 sentences in negative, okay? Come on, do it. And delegada, no me has hecho acordar la foto a la asistencia. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna give you 5 minutes to do that. Mientras que ahorita les tomo la foto, wait a minute. Please open your webcam to take the para tomar la foto, please. Open your webcam. Vamos a tomar la foto de la asistencia. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Everybody cheese. Okay, good. Okay. Good. So ready, come on, please. You have only 2 minutes to make your sentence in simple past. Okay, affirmative. We are not working negative, no interrogative for now. Just affirmative, okay? 1 minute, te queda 1 minuto. Okay, for example, I have my sentence. I already have my sentence. Let me show you. Te voy a mostrar aquí. Okay, para eso voy a quitar mi fondo. Okay, come on, write. Escribe tu oración, apúrate. Perdón, 3 oraciones, ya saben, usando el simple past, okay?
¿Lo escribimos en el chat para todos o lo escribimos en el
privado? Sí, lo pueden escribir en el chat, lo pueden utilizar la pizarra.
Mismo, no lo enviamos.
La pizarra. Sorry. Sí, lo envían en el chat, pero cuando lo envíen en el chat, no lo envíen en private, no lo envíen en privado, okay? Lo envían para todo el salón. ¿Eh? O lo pueden mostrar así como yo, in a paper, o lo pueden decir orally. Okay, for example, that's my sentence. I played with my son yesterday. Okay, I have a little son and I played with him yesterday. And I use a regular verb, si se dieron cuenta, o sea, un verbo regular. You can use a regular and irregular verb, or any verb, cualquier verbo que tú quieras. Okay, so let me know if you are ready. You have to use 3 of them, 3 oraciones. Okay. Okay, Piero, nos equivoquemos o no, tenemos que ponerlo en el chat para todos. Así nos damos cuenta de nuestros errores, ¿ok? Ok, Piero, please, the next time, no in private, ¿ok? He was the man who saved my life. Very good, Piero. Micaela, they went to the cinema with Julia. Perfect. Okay. Yes, Hazel, we already take the list. Sí, Hazel, tenías que haberme avisado antes, pues, para tomar la lista. Pero that's okay, thank you. Okay, Dayali, they singing. Okay, Dayali, they singing. Singing is no basa. Be careful.
Me equivoqué.
Okay, era para el otro chat. Yeah, be careful. Okay, Piero, he was the man. Yeah, Piero, that's okay. Perfect. Pasa. What sentence, Jennifer? Tú tienes que crear las oraciones. Okay, Ibrahim, he started for his English class, Okay, thank you. I hope that's your case. Okay, good, Ibrahim. Hazel, Jen wrote a special letter for her boyfriend. Very good, Hazel. Okay, Jennifer, you have to write three sentences. Y para poder exponerlas, puedes ponerlas en el chat, puedes usar la pizarra interactiva, mostrármelo en un cartel, ¿ok? Pero tres oraciones sin simple past. Kalawa, you work very hard last week. She lived in Japan last year. I painted my house last weekend. Very good. Okay, Emerson, he danced in the school. Ibrahim, he always walked to school. Very good, Manly. I ate real chicken. I wrote a poem breakfast a few years ago. Okay, be careful, Manly. Acá estás mezclando dos oraciones con un final inesperado, something like that. I ate real chicken for breakfast, maybe, right? I wrote a poem a few hours ago, could be. Okay. Dayali, they singing in the karaoke. Okay, they were singing. Okay, very good.
Pero este ya no es simple.
Okay, very good. Pero ya no es de simple past. Aquí sería simple past continuous. Okay, but that's okay.